So in this video, I want to change your thinking when it comes to picking products to dropship using Facebook ads. One of the biggest reasons why I see people failing is because they pick the wrong products. Now, they don't necessarily pick bad products, they just don't pick products that are suitable, suitable being the keyword in this video. To give you an example then, if we take this sponge holder here, we can see as a product solely, it's pretty decent. It's got over 5,000 orders, nearly 2,000 reviews, and a 4.7 star rating. But if you ask me, it's not a very suitable product for Facebook. And the reason being then is because when you choose a product for a particular platform, you have to take into account the kind of mood that your customer is going to be in. So for example then, if you're going to sell a product on Amazon or using Google Ads, then they are the kind of platforms that people go on to find things they want to buy. Whereas if you're going to advertise a product on Facebook, people don't go onto Facebook to find things they want to buy. They go into Facebook to stalk their friends or get updated with what people are up to or watch funny meme videos, whatever it is. It's a whole multitude of reasons, but ultimately they're not on Facebook to buy something. So you have to take that into account when you're picking products. And the reason being then is because the competition is different. So for example, if you advertise a product on Google Ads or Amazon, the kind of platform where people go to buy things, they're in a buying mood, they're looking to spend money. However, on those platforms are other products that they can buy. So your competition on those platforms are similar products. You have to compete on quality, price, the cost of delivery, speed of delivery, customer service, those kind of things. Whereas when you're advertising on Facebook, then your competition is your customers' friends, your customers' family, the pages your customers follow in. It could be any other app on their mobile phone. And the reason being for this then is because when somebody's on Facebook, they're not looking for your ad, they're looking for other things. So essentially you're competing for their competition. And obviously with them being on Facebook, their competition is going to involve those things I just mentioned. So it could be a post from their friends, it could be even somebody ringing them on a phone call that takes them off of Facebook and away from your ad. It could be a certain page that they're following. So that is what your competition is. So when it comes to selling a product like this sponge holder, even though it's quite a good product in its own solely, if somebody's on Facebook, they're scrolling through and they've got two options. Option A is to watch that funny dog video, which is going to make them laugh, which they'd love to tag their friends in. Or option B is to watch your Facebook video on a sponge holder. Then I'm no sidekick, but I could probably guess they would rather watch a dog video because it's funny and it's more appealing, and therefore they're not going to take notice of your sponge holder. Now this doesn't mean we're completely doomed then. All it means then is that we have to pick certain products that match certain criteria to give them the best chance of success on Facebook. And that's exactly what I'm going to go through in this video then. So I've got a checklist of different points to go through one by one. And next time you're picking a product, as long as these products match this checklist, then trust me, it's going to give you a much better chance of finding success. So that's the topic of the video then. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoy it. If you do, please make sure you let me know by hitting that like button. Any comments or questions or video suggestions as well, please do post them below. I read every single comment, by the way, so if there's something you want me to see, simply just post it down below. And finally, if you haven't yet subscribed, please do make sure you do for regular content, at least 4 videos every single week. And that being said then, let's jump straight into point number one. So point number one is that this product that you pick that you're going to advertise using Facebook must be an impulse buy. So by definition, an impulse buy is an unplanned decision to buy a product or service. So we can take this sink, for example, that you can see you can source from AliExpress. People don't necessarily buy a new kitchen sink on impulse. It's usually a decision that they'll think about for a number of days, if not weeks, maybe even months. They may even have to save up for it. So trying to get somebody to buy your expensive sink on impulse is going to be really difficult to do. Whereas to give you an example of where it might be easier to do would be to sell this product on Amazon or Google, because they're the kind of places where people will search for a sink, cheap sink or expensive sink or high quality sink, and therefore you can target people looking to buy a sink, whereas you can't really do that on Facebook. And to kind of summarize it up nicely, I've got this kind of like humorous image here, but that's the exact kind of reaction that we want to be looking for in our customers. When they see our product, you need to get them to be thinking, I've just got to buy this. And that is essentially in its whole one impulse buy is. Moving on to point number two then is the cost. So my recommendation is less than 50 pounds. And the reason being then is because the more expensive your product is, the more times your customer will have to see it before they buy it. I.e. you'll need a higher frequency score on your Facebook ads, and you'll have to capitalize using retargeting ads. And again, just to kind of illustrate that nicely, if you were to try and advertise a product like this, a £4,000 drone, now I know it's a bit of an extreme example, but it kind of illustrates it nicely. The more expensive your product is, the more time your customer may have to consider buying it. They may even have to save up for it, and therefore they'll have to see that ad more times over a longer period, and therefore, as it says there, you're going to need a higher frequency score and spend more money on retargeting ads. So by choosing products then that cost less than £50, then you open yourself up to a whole wider range and broader market, because people will be more willing to spend less than £50 on impulse than they will say £100, and therefore your conversion rate is going to be higher. Moving on to the third and final point of this presentation then, I forgot to mention it in the beginning, but as it says here, this keynote will be available for download. It'll be 100% free, so just make sure you check out the first link in the description below, and I'll also put it in the top comment as well. So the third point then, the third and final point, is a sub-niche audience. So your product has to be relevant to what I'm going to call a sub-niche in this video. The reason I'm going to call it a sub-niche then is because the term niche gets thrown around way too broadly, when in reality you need to choose a true niche, or what I'm going to call a sub-niche, because niche by definition then is denoting or relating to products, services or interests that appeal to a small specialized section of the population. So for example then, somebody will call the dog niche a niche when in reality it's not. It's something like 13 million people in the UK have a dog, so that's not a small specialized section of the population. It's quite a broad audience, if you like. So to kind of illustrate this nicely, what I'm going to call a sub-niche then is, if you take dogs as the niche, if you like, then the sub-niche will be particular dog breeds, and therefore it's a more specific and specialized section of an audience. And to kind of summarize this nicely then, to illustrate it, we have two dog products here. We have pug socks, which are really good because they appeal to a small specialized section of the dog audience, and then we just have like a generic dog product which appeals to any dog or cat owner. So the reason this one's got a green tick then is because it appeals to a very specific set of people. And the reason why this is such a good thing then is because when somebody's on Facebook and they're watching different videos or reading different posts or stalking somebody, if they see something that is really relatable to them and they have a specific link to that product, so for example, if we take the casual pug owner, they have one pug, two pugs, it doesn't matter, and they're scrolling through on Facebook, if they see both of these products one after the other, which one are they more likely to buy, or which one are they more likely to notice for a start? It's going to be these pug socks here, because they own a pug. This pug on that socks looks like their pug, and they have a stronger link and connection to these pug socks versus this dog brush, which is just generic and will appeal to any dog or cat owner. And that's kind of in its essence. Trust me, it's small points, there's only 3 points, but if you can pick products that match all three of these criteria, it will completely transform the results you get on Facebook. It's all about getting noticed, it's all about capturing people's attention, and by picking a product that appeals to a certain person, a specific audience, then it's going to get a lot more eyes on, it's going to get a lot more engagement, a lot more people tagging, sharing, etc., because it's for a specific type of audience. The broader your audience is, the more likely somebody is just to kind of scan through it and not even notice the products you've just spent money on advertising. With that being said then, that is it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you want more content off of YouTube, I tend to post every day on Instagram, so make sure you go ahead, check me out. Download this keynote if you want. You can click the link, it will take you straight to my profile. If not, make sure you check out my free ebooks in the video description below. There's 5 different ones, completely free, 100% free, so go check those out, download them. And finally then, if you do want a proven e-commerce program with step-by-step videos and guidance, then make sure you check out my e-com academy too. And again, there will be a link for that in the video description below. And apart from that, thanks very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully see you in the next one.